To the 2021 Honoring of International Students. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the evening for class of 2021. We now bring on stage your host, a popular blogger from Silliman University High School. Please welcome Nikhal Mahi. Go Nick, go!
Oh wow, I'm currently here in the amphitheater and right behind me is the iconic Oriental Hall. Did you know the iconic Oriental Hall and the amphitheater turned 100 years this year? We are celebrating the centennial of our iconic landmarks, and this is the reason we are bringing you to the class of 2021. My name is Nikhal Mahi, and my family is originated from India, but basically we have shifted here in Dumaguete City. I'm so excited to be here with you all, so let's begin it with a prayer by Revenant Wella de Rosas.
Let us pray. Our gracious and loving God, we are here today with the international community gathered virtually in your name. Today we come with grateful hearts as we savor and give thanks for all the students who are with us in this virtual celebration. Thank you that you have created each one of us with all the potentials and skills to do great things in your name. And we praise you for leading us in all the learning experiences in life. O Lord, in this very moment, be with us in our celebration as we enjoy this success that you have given us. We pray that we may all feel proud this day and enjoy in sharing these achievements with our family and friends. Bless our gathering, O Lord. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Wella. We will formally open this event with the words by our Dean of Students, Dr. Edna Gladys Teves Calingacion.
To our guest of honor, the Senator of Indonesia, the Honorable Senator Welim T. P. Simarmata, our beloved President, Dr. Betty Sernol Macan, our Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Earl Jude Cleope, our Vice President for Finance and Administration, Dr. Jenny Chu, and Professor Jane Annette Bilarmino, our Vice President for Development. Our University Pastoral Team, represented by Reverend Wella Hoyle de Rosas, Minister for Students and Campus Chaplain. My fellow OSS Family Care Team members, celebrating the 100th birthday of Oriental Hall, and to our dearest members of Class 2021 from our international community, good evening. The sharing of knowledge is just as important as receiving it, because without sharing, knowledge has no value. We thank you for the gift of courage, traveling far from your home country with your aim to discover new horizons in your life in Siliman University. And we thank you for the willingness to share with an open mind the new things you dared to try and discover. You have successfully challenged yourself, even if there were doubts at the beginning of your journey. Now, you are ready to answer questions and solve problems, or at least be a part of the solution of these huge challenges that this pandemic has given to our world. We are confident that you will find new ways to do the same task in your home and for the world you are about to conquer. We are confident that you will find new ways to do the same task in your home and for the world you are about to conquer. Always have the heart of a Silimanian within you. Your family here in Siliman will always be here. As you continue to make life something you want to reminisce on, which is very much how you made your stay in the Philippines, truly unforgettable. Continue to be just so nice to people and to be more welcoming. I think this is one great lesson you have learned from the joyful environment around your Filipino friends. So, welcome to this celebration of your success. And congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Ate Edna. That was wonderful. Very touching indeed. Now, here is a special song number by a member of class 2021, Zong Kong, a master in music student in Myanmar.
Now I'm going to play a Filipino piece entitled Dam Dam Min by Duke Camino.
Thank you.
Thank you, Zong. A beautiful touch of culture. I'm sure it may bring home our international students. We will continue to pray for peace over Myanmar, and may God protect our fellow Silimanians in Myanmar. Now, to formally introduce our invited speaker, the Honorable Senator from Indonesia, please welcome the Kuya ng Bayan, our beloved international student's advisor, Kuya Moses Joshua Atega.
Good morning. We are celebrating the 100th birthday of the amphitheater and Oriental Hall. And yes, these will be the venue for the honoring of the 2021 class. We're so proud of you, and we give you the best as our guest of honor. It is my pleasure to introduce him. And in this very special event, we also celebrate the homecoming on one big story of success that I'm sure his teachers would love to witness. Yes, the person that I'm about to introduce was actually the president of the graduate students when he was still studying here, and I was actually the secretary when that set of pioneering officers was organized in 1990. As president, he was a very dynamic one that had so many events, and he was nonstop, and he had so much time for church events, and he was actually preaching at the pulpit of Silliman Church. And now he is here for a virtual homecoming. Our guest of honor is from Medan, Sumatera Utara, Indonesia. He's an ordained minister and took responsibilities while on active service to the Christian ministry in this Muslim country. He graduated with a diploma in mission and technology from Hanel Theological Seminary in Sungju, Kulabukdu in South Korea. Earlier than that, he finished his educational management degree from Silliman University in 1990. Yes, we are proud of this alumnus. He was on full scholarship from the United Evangelical Mission based on Wuppertal, Germany. And it is interesting to note that he actually became the moderator of UEM in 2016 up to this year, 2021. We are familiar with this German foundation as they have sent so many scholars to our university, especially in the graduate school and the Divinity School. Shortly prior to this, he was a member of the World Council of Churches Central Committee starting in 2015 up to 2010. He had so many undertakings related to the ministry, and not just within Indonesia, but in other countries as well, and which eventually lead to his being elected senator. And he has been a member of the Senate of the Republic of Indonesia since his election in 2019 and will be serving until 2024. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pride and honor that we present to you the Honorable Senator of Indonesia, Reverend Dr. William Tipi Simarmata. Our very own, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause.
It is a great privilege for me, as alumnus of Silliman University in 1989 and former United Evangelical Mission Scholarship holder, to share this video with you. Thank you very much to the committee who entrusted me to speak virtually before you, our proud graduates and former international student of Silliman University in Dumaguete City, the Philippines. Initially, I would like to greet you all and express my appreciation of your academic achievement. Congratulations. This could be the last stage of your academic journey, but I have to welcome you to a tangible university of life, which will challenge you heavier than your study assignment at the Silliman University. I was asked to talk about faith armor in facing today's challenges. I assume that the word armor is not associated to the current military powers and violence. If I understood correctly, the phrase armor of God is originated from Ephesians 6, verse 11. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. As an armor of God, St. Paul mentioned the various armor pieces the Christians should put on, namely the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helm of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. In biblical exegesis, the vast majority of biblical scholars agree that Paul used the concept armor as a reference to spiritual battle against the devil. The term devil refers to the rulers, the authorities, the power of this dark world, and the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Faith, as the armor of God, contains not only spiritual, but also dynamic and pragmatic faith. Speaking about my faith, I will tell you some stories from the time of my theological studies and ministries. In 1976, together with 173 theological students of Nomensen University in Pematang Siantar, we decided to migrate from our campus to another exile room to show our opposition against the tyrannical policies of our university leader and a prominent capital owner. Two decades later, I was forced to stay in a military prison for some days since I had been protesting against the dictatorial regime Suharto, who exercised its power in the church leadership of the Batak Church. I believe that there are always consequences behind any faithful decision and action of disciples of Christ. I am of the opinion that courage is one expression of several faith attitudes. Our reformer, Dr. Martin Luther, uttered is very briefly, "Here I stand. I can do no other. God help me. Amen." This strong statement was his commitment of faith. In addition to it, I was so honored to have a chance to take a short theological study in South Korea in order to examine the Minjung theology, which was regarded as the primary post-colonial theology in the Asian context. Faith, according to the Minjung theology, is focused on Jesus as the friend of the poor and his powerlessness during his crucifixion leading up to his resurrection. Let me draw your attention on the three prevailing challenges, especially during the outbreaks of COVID-19. First, economic and political injustice has created a deep gulf between the rich and the poor countries. This gap has also fostered various racial, religious, and ideological conflicts that have resulted in millions of deaths and even deteriorated until today. Series of terrorist acts in the name of religion evidence the said economic and political inequality as the heritage of past imperial supremacists. Racial and discriminative violence against the Lumad communities in the Philippines, Papuan societies in Indonesia, and minority groups in many parts of Asian contexts can be considered as the scheme of evil which threatens our democratization. Second, destruction of our Mother Earth, the document of Kairos of creation, confessing hope for the earth in Uppertal Call in German, has warned these global disasters. Our earth is exploited by human greediness and unlimited culture and materialism. The ecumenical communities have failed to maintain justice amid poverty, inequality, and climate calamities. Climate destruction has been forcing an increasing number of people to migration and becoming climate refugees. We need to confess our sins that we won't be able to bequeath our planet to the next generation. As an impact of my critical comments against the forest destruction in Tapanuli, North Sumatra of Indonesia, I was again imprisoned in a small and cold jail for some days. Third, the wild digitalization. The pandemic of COVID-19 has brainstormed our conscience to be a digital change, whether we are ready or not. Digital koinonia requires a radical transformation to be a fellowship based on the Bible and internet connection. The church and its educational institution are called to respond to it wisely by searching ethical values on challenging theological issues, which were not accustomed before. Some critical questions were raised, such as possibilities for online Holy Communion and baptism in time of emerging disasters. Digitalization, which has saved our global communities and interconnection, unfortunately, also has harmed our civilization. There are accountable cases of women and children trafficking by using online transactions. Drug trafficking has been increasingly accelerated by online dealers. My question will be, how does Silliman University react to the challenge I mentioned before? In order to face our today's challenges, the academic societies of Silliman University must be equipped with the armor of God by putting on the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helm of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. The transfer of knowledge has never been sufficient to defeat the scheme of evil. The churches in the Philippines are renowned to be the body of Christ, which identifies their faith by taking side with the poor, the marginalized, and the raped earth. I encourage you all, the graduates worldwide and academic members of the Silliman University, to reveal your keen Christian faith actively in the world torn apart. Your faith as the armor of God should be demonstrated in being the bridging element between spiritual formation and science, as well as in act solidarity in order to save a just and peaceful global community. Let me close my speech by a testimony of a survivor of Nazi concentration camp. To all educators, I am a survivor of a concentration camp. My eyes saw what no person should witness: gas chambers built by learned engineers, children poisoned by educated physicians, infants killed by trained nurses, women and babies sought by high school and college graduates, so I am suspicious of education. My request in this, help your young generation, your children, become human, become human. Your effort must never produce learned monster, skilled psychopath, or educated Aikman, reading, writing, and arithmetic are important only if they serve to make our children more human. Fifat Academica, Fifat Professores, maraming salamat po.
We are proud of you, Honorable Senator William of Indonesia. Thank you very much for the wonderful message. Now, let's have a special song for Class of 2021 from the QFQ or Kiso Family Quintet. Thank you, QFQ, for the gift of music.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Girlie Serafica Rosales of USA from the College of Nursing.
Coming to the halls of Silliman as a foreign student was nothing short of anxiety-inducing at first. I didn't quite know what to expect, actually, but however, as I had gone through my 4 years of being a nursing student, until now, as I look back at things, I'm still very surprised. So through these 4 years, I have encountered many soulful people as well as acquired quite the knowledge, skills, and a great attitude in the current and also my future careers and endeavors. I was able to learn more about myself and even surpass expectations that I had of myself, which of that was not solely done alone, but with the help of my family, my friends, the faculty and staff of my college, and everyone else around me who had supported me along the way throughout this journey. So through these 4 years, I've learned to become more resilient in the sense of having a greater self-motivation, determination, as well as independence to do the best that I can, not only for myself, but also for my family and towards the community. Making the decision to actually come here to Philippines and study in this university was not an easy decision to make. However, I can definitely say now that it is one of the best decisions that I have made for myself. And although some things didn't quite go according to plan, they all still fell in their proper places, landing themselves perfectly in imperfect puzzle areas, but still making it all a wholesome experience and a wholesome journey.
We are so proud of you. Please welcome back the QFQ for another special song.
Great is the Lord, He is holy and just, by His power we trust in His love. Great is the Lord, He is faithful and true, by His mercy He proves His love. Great is the Lord and worthy of glory, great is the Lord and worthy of praise. Great is the Lord, now lift up your voice, now lift up your voice. Great is the Lord. Great is the Lord. Great is the Lord, He is holy and just, by His power we trust in His love. Great is the Lord, He is faithful and true, by His mercy He proves His love. Great is the Lord and worthy of glory, great is the Lord and worthy of praise. Great is the Lord, now lift up your voice, now lift up your voice.
Thank you again, QFQ. What a very touching moment to see one family singing. Together, the members of the QFQ are Johnny James, their father, Miriam, their mother, and their equally talented children, Johnny Riam, Ona, and Yeshua. Thank you for your beautiful music. Now, our next testimonial will be shared to us by the brilliant student from Korea. Please welcome Sun Ryong Ok. She is taking care of Bachelor of Foreign Affairs under the school Public Affairs and Governance.
Hi everyone, I'm Sun, and a few days from now, I'll be officially graduating as a student in Siliman. While we can celebrate the now, the past 2 years was not easy. There were a lot of low points in my life, and most of them were behind closed doors. But in those times, I always think about why I am doing what I do in the first place. First, I would like to thank my dream team, my family, for being my life teachers and supporters as well, to keep me morally grounded as I pave through different challenges in life. I would also like to thank my friends inside and outside school that I made in Dumaguete, my professors. You've given me more than I can give. Life lessons, experiences, late nights studying and partying, strolling the boulevard, motorbiking to places I thought I'd only see in photos, fiestas and food trips across the cities, becoming a tourist in my own city. I'll never regret the day I saw Siliman as a school beside the sea, 3,186 kilometers away in my square blue screen, and decided this is for me. I am proud to have internalized the culture and the beauty of Dumaguete, and I'm sure I will carry this part of my life for many, many years to come, especially ang pagkabisaya na ako, no? I know for our batch previews and future batch, there's going to be fear of changes, of instability, of failures. But not being where you want to be in life has to become a motivation to get where you want to be. Otherwise, you'll start drowning in self-doubt and self-pity and settle for the life you've God instead of moving towards the life you want. And always remember at the same time to move forward on your own pace, on your own time. Congratulations, everyone.
She is very talented and a consistent honor student. We are proud of you, Sunryong. And now, you will have to join us as it is now time to honor class of 2021. May I now request Kuya Mo and Ate Edna to do the honors. Congratulations, and we are so proud of you, Class 2021.
Sa anak si
Now, time to ensure the future with a new set of officers. We request Ate Edna and Pastor Wella to be our inducting officers.
Thank you. Let us pray. Our Almighty and gracious God, in this time of virtual gathering, we celebrate the installation of responsible leaders of the recently concluded election of the international students community here in Silliman University. Lord God, we ask that you will bless our brothers and sisters who have declared their willingness to humbly follow in the footsteps of serving the community. Lord, we pray that you will give them the wisdom on the difficult and challenging days during their leadership. We ask that each of them would submit themselves to you, O God, as the greatest leader of all. We pray that you would move their hearts and minds to protect the rights and welfare of each international student, uphold religious freedom, and recognize family and gender rights as they promote unity and harmony amidst the diversity in culture and tradition. For you, O God, is the one who beautifully and perfectly created all of us. We are also grateful, O God, for the lives of our outgoing leaders who have faithfully served the international students' community during their terms of leadership, leading the members to an increased love for Jesus Christ. In gratitude for their diligent efforts, we ask that you would bless them with wisdom that they may carry on in their learning and journey of life. Loving God, we give you thanks for the many and varied ways in which you build up our community and our students. Bless these officers of the international students community. Grant that they may be of service to you and bring honor and glory to your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Congratulations to our new officers for the next school year. More power to you. Let me share you this quote. A leader is best when people barely know he exists. When his work is done, his aim fulfilled, they will say, "We did it ourselves." So again, congratulations to all of you. May we now call on Pastor Wella for the send-off through prayer and benediction.
Let us now end this gathering with a prayer. Let us pray. Indeed, O Lord, today is a celebration of your faithfulness to us. You have called us into a life of success and integrity, and we are grateful to you for sustaining us with your grace throughout the years. And now we are able to enjoy the fruit of our hard work. And as we end this virtual gathering, we pray that you would bless us and keep us safe. All this we pray in Jesus' name. And now, children of God, may God's blessing be upon you. May you live an abundant and successful life, the one that God has promised to all those who follow Him. Go and be the blessing to others. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
There's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no horror, sorrow. Girl.